Hello guys, this is Obtain, owner of Meal Prep Sunday San Diego. This is our second interview with the people that we think they achieve really, really big things in the fitness field on their own body. So we want to interview them to see how they did it. This time, Chrissy. So, Chrissy, let us know about yourself. Tell us about basically what you're doing. Kind of short summary about yourself from the time that you start. What happened you get into the fitness, and just about yourself, kind of brief information about yourself.
I was turning 30 years old, and all my girlfriends were kind of like, oh, I'm fat, or I need to lose weight, or this big weight, and I was like, hell no, I'm not gonna let it be an excuse. I'm going to get into the gym, start training. From there, I entered my first competition. It was a bikini competition in Las Vegas. Right off the bat, I did very well. There was, I think, 37 girls in my class. And they instantly, when I got the feedback, said I was too big already as far as muscular. I knew nothing about this competing thing, nothing. I just set kind of a goal to get my body, my mind, my body, my soul, everything to that point. So that was just kind of something fun with my family to go and do. And this time I had separated from my husband. We were kind of going through a rough patch. I've been with him since I was 19 years old. He's 9 years older than me. We own a really large company. We just were butting heads a little bit. So we had separated. We're going through a divorce. I was so sad. And for me, my energy, I wanted to get it out in a good way. So I didn't want to be going to the bars. I didn't want to be drinking. I didn't want to be sleeping around or doing these things. My first one was all natural. I believe it was IMBA. I won figure overall.
Yeah.
Because in the bikini contest, they had told me I was a little bit too big. So I said, why not? Let's do figure. Let's do the posing. Let's do the diet, the everything.
And the difference between figure and bikini is that bikini is really focusing on the strength, on the muscles, on like full body, and bikini is basically focusing more on basically how, mostly on your glutes or your butt, and just basically how you look like in terms of sexiness from the female.
Yes.
So kind of like for people to know that.
Yes, it was good, positive energy. The girls were amazing. The people I were around were always putting me up. Oh, you look great, like good job, you know. Positive energy, nothing negative. So in that moment, I'm like, that's it, that's what I wanna do. Obviously taking the back seat to being a mom and a, you know, all these other things. Everybody at my gym was competing in NPC, everybody's kinda pushing me, come on, let's do it. I said, okay. So at this time, I'm training, I'm getting ready, I'm so excited, I had picked a contest, and my dad passed away. In the middle of the night, he had had melanoma in just one of his moles 7 years earlier. They had thought they had gotten all of it in surgery, and it had metastasized to his brain and took him in the middle of the night. So devastated. I mean, my dad was my rock, you know, especially going through a divorce. I went to my dad for everything, you know? So that was the hardest thing I have ever been through in my life. Then I was like, I'm done competing. I'm done, you know, all that. I just want to focus on my kids, the other things in my life. I had all these signs, you know, just kept pushing me to the fitness, pushing me to the fitness. Like, your dad is the one that wanted you to do this. He's the one that wanted you to be on stage and win and be in the magazines and do the photo shoots and all this. Like, he's always wanted that for me. So I sucked it up, and I'm like, you know, what got me through my separation, what got through me, you know, my sadness, all that. And I had forgot my gramps had also passed away 2 years before that. So that's another reason I got into fitness. It just made me, I was sad. So it was a good outlet for me, if that makes sense. So started getting back into training. Crazy, crazy thing happened. Me and my husband reconnected 2 weeks before our divorce was final. And he at that time was like, I don't want you to compete anymore. And I said, I've always been my own person. He's never changed who I am, nothing like that. I'm very strong, obviously. I said, if you do not want me to compete, then I do not think we should get back together. The fitness, the health, the way that I feel, like I wake up every morning and I'm like, good morning, how are you? To my kids, to my family, to my clients, to anybody at the store, 7-Eleven, or getting gas or whatever. Without that, I don't have that energy, I don't feel good, and I don't feel complete. And just like that, he's like, okay, babe, whatever you want. I got your back. We'll do this together. Whatever. So from then on, competed again, won again, won again. Then I'm like, okay, what's next? I want to do something different. So I've always wanted to do WBFF, which is a dream of mine. It's international. The girls are beautiful, but they focus more on health and fitness and how a person looks maybe in whole compared to just
but
this. That's yeah. It. They look above this. They look at this. They look at your energy coming out of you, your personality, your love for the sport. It's an overall fitness, you know, journey. Going from an organization where it is so tough on you have to eat like this, and if you even steer out of it, your body doesn't react. I'm over that. Like, I have 3 children. Like, I have family. I want to have a healthy lifestyle. So especially getting older, I have a lot of women that look up to me that say constantly on a daily basis that I'm an inspiration because I'm a mom, not of just one child, but 3 children.
Okay. So Chrissy is basically our top performance athletes that we have on Meal Prep Sunday San Diego. And right now, like everybody in especially the age of 20 or 18 to 25, it's what they want to do to become an influencer. I mean, that influencers in terms of having their life to basically get paid by Instagram or posting or something like that, or having a lot of affiliation. And she has amazing, basically, influence on everybody around. So give some tips to the people that basically they're trying to achieve it when they're 18, for the young age, for 18 to 25. Because I know that you have done it. I know that you achieved basically everything at that time even.
Yes.
How did you do that? How would you do if you're 18 right now? How did you accomplish that type of relationship with the people that are following you?
I was myself. I wasn't fake. I said everything. Like, if I woke up and had the worst day and missed my dad and, like, you know, was sad about my divorce, like, I said it. I was never fake. If I'm in off season and I'm fluffy, I posted it.
So anything else that you want to mention for people around, for people same age, or for female younger, for working out, for fitness, anything last word that you have for them?
I think my biggest thing is not to get wrapped up in it for the wrong reasons. Like, really focus
on... What's
the
wrong reason?
Like, don't get into it and like win or like let a coach or anybody around you sway you towards like the drugs and certain things. Like, I feel like you need to do it for the right reasons, like for your body, for your health, for your mental health. Because, you know, if you want to live and be on this earth, then you have to take care of yourself. Some people in the industry, they're like, I don't give a shit if I die after the competition, if I win. Like, that's their mindset. And I'm not, like, taking anything away from them. If that is, if you really don't care and, like, that's what you're doing, then okay. But a lot of those people's relationships, they fail. They're not doing good at work, you know? They have bad energy. They're grumpy all the time. Like, yeah, I mean, everything affects your body. So getting into it, focus on your health. Focus on being an overall healthy person. If you wanna compete, compete. Like, it's amazing. Like, that feeling that you have on stage and winning. I mean, I remember my first contest in NPC. I did figure and I won and I just cried like this on stage. And I, when I did look up, all the judges were teary-eyed. If I win, I win, and it's because I earned it, not because somebody gave it to me. But I didn't just go in ever expecting it. I still don't expect anything. Like, with WBFF, these girls are freaking insane. Like, they are a little bit older, so their muscle maturity is so freaking beautiful. Like, it's ridiculous. Like, you know, some of the big bodybuilders, like, their muscle is beautiful because they've just done it year after year. I mean, they've eaten so clean. They've done maybe supplements or steroids or whatever, but they're still putting in the work. They're still doing it. At the end of the day, if you want to compete, do it for yourself.
So thank you for your time. Chris will answer all of your questions. Just take a snapshot from the YouTube that you're watching or the trailer. Tag her, ask her, she will DM you back. And thank you for your time. Next time we will have another guest, but the best guest ever, Chrissy. Take care.